A large Canadian goose laying in tall green grass. Water in the distance, and beyond that, a city's skyline with skyscrapers. Text, protecting and preserving urban national parks by the National Park Service Inventory and Monitoring Program. A tour boat labeled Harbor Islands approaching a dock. Text, Mark Albert, Natural Resources Partnerships Director, Boston Harbor Islands National Recreation Area.
So urban parks are both tremendous opportunity and a tremendous challenge. We have, you know, thousands and thousands of people who are coming out to enjoy them every year, and we want those folks out enjoying the park.
A variety of seabirds standing on rocks near the water. A crab walking slowly through grass. Two gray goslings.
We also have birds and rocky intertidal critters and mammals and plant communities that are, you know, holding on and surviving in this densely populated area. So our fundamental challenge is balancing protection of the resources of the park with visitor use and all the other uses associated with an urban harbor and the islands out here.
National Park Service and Department of Conservation and Recreation logos. Text, bird nesting, Boston Harbor Islands National and State Park. Carolyn Trockey, lead partner scientist, coastal breeding bird monitoring.
So the park includes over 35 islands and peninsulas in Boston Harbor. So you're right off the city skyline. So like the view right behind me, you know, you're sort of constantly brought back to the fact that there are millions of people at your doorstep. Nesting water birds are a resource that's been identified as being one of the things that's really unique to Boston Harbor and special about the park. And the Park Service is held accountable for being able to manage, to try and protect those species, to pay attention to how they're doing. So this monitoring protocol was set up to look at a few different species of birds, wading birds, herons and egrets, double-crested cormorants, a few different species of gulls, shorebirds that nest on the beaches, all of these birds that really rely on this unique coastal habitat. And our goal is to go out on an annual basis and see how they're doing, keep track of how they're doing, find out if there are changes over time, trends that we can see happening.
Scientists watching birds through binoculars, taking notes, and using tablets.
So we do it every year. We don't do all of the same work every year. We actually work on a 3-year rotation. So in 3 years, we manage to get around to all of the things we want to keep track of in the islands. So by doing it every 3 years, we are able to put together a timeline that lets us see changes as they happen while there's still time to do something about it. So hopefully we can catch declines or shifts in location more readily than if we only came in every 10 years or every 20 years and did a snapshot.
People on the beach with binoculars. Text, urban parks, volunteers, citizen science.
Volunteers have been an awesome part of this program. I started this work working solo or with other researchers, and the Park Service wanted to make it a volunteer program, and I thought, oh my God, how is that ever going to work?
Four people in a small boat.
In fact, it's the part that I think I love best about it.
Various people watching different birds.
The Coastal Breeding Bird Monitoring Program is really our best example of citizen science right now. These volunteers are dedicated and become real advocates both for the park and for the biodiversity of the park.
A cannon in a grassy field with a wooden fence on forest in the distance. Text, Manassas National Battlefield Park. Sign, First Manassas Loop Trail, 5.5 miles. A woman standing near a row of cannons writing. Text, urban parks, monitoring birds.
Inventory and monitoring monitors parks across the nation. So while we might be monitoring birds in Boston Harbor Islands, we're also monitoring them at Manassas National Battlefield Park. It's a park that preserves a Civil War landscape. It's surrounded by suburban development. It's not far from Washington, D.C.
Busy highway.
And so it's an urban park.
A small bird sitting on a branch, then flying away. A woman makes a note.
It's really an oasis for all kinds of wildlife, including forest and grassland birds.
Text, Megan Northrup, science communicator, National Capital Region Inventory and Monitoring Network.
Because of its urban setting, Manassas is subject to traffic noise.
Cars driving past fields.
There are roads that go right through the park and air pollution. And those are things that birds can be very sensitive to. So when we monitor birds in Manassas, we're checking on how they're faring in the face of these things.
A small bird lands on the head of a statue of Stonewall Jackson.
The diversity of bird species at Manassas really shows how valuable they are to wildlife.
A busy street next to a wooded area. Sign, National Park Service, U.S. Department of the Interior, Rock Creek Park.
Rock Creek Park, which is set in the middle of the city of Washington, D.C., has a similar role. Rock Creek is a really special place. It's been protected for a long time, and that has allowed some really mature trees to develop here. And there are certain wildlife species that really need those big, mature trees.
A wooded area. Text Rock Creek Park Forest.
People might be really surprised to learn the number of animals that live in an urban park like this.
A red fox near the edge of the wood.
There are animals you see, like fox, squirrels, and then there are a lot of animals that you may not ever see.
Deer crossing a trail.
There's flying squirrels. There are bats, brown bats, red bats. There's even a threatened northern long-eared bat in this park.
Removing a bat caught in a net. Text Urban Parks Bat Survey, Rock Creek Park. Using a flashlight to look at its wings, the bat perches on a gloved hand, then flies away.
It's really incredible that an urban park can be home to some of these most vulnerable species.
People hiking through the woods.
The forest is what makes up the habitat for all the wildlife that lives in this park, and it's really one of the things that people enjoy when they visit here.
Uniformed parks employee with tablet. Text Urban Parks Forest Monitoring.
Our monitoring gives us a sense of the health of the forest. It gives us a picture of the species balance of plants, the age of the forest, and whether it's under any stress.
Measuring around a mature tree with tape.
We're using science to know the condition of these important places, and we're not guessing. That's why it's so important that we're doing this for the long term.
The particular value of the inventory and monitoring program in an urban park is that any urban environment is going to have a lot of stressors and unknown stressors in the future. The monitoring that we do allows us to understand what's going on with the biodiversity and ecosystems in the park amidst that chaos of the urban environment.
National Park Service logo. Text cooperatively produced by the following inventory and monitoring networks: Northeast Temperate, Eastern Rivers and Mountains, Mid-Atlantic, National Capital Region, with the help of the Boston Harbor Islands National Recreation Area, Manassas National Battlefield Park, Rock Creek Park.